Good morning. I'm Rhonda Mitchell. I'm the Children's Ministry Director at Anchor Point Church. I'm here to share a few thoughts with you this morning. As we've been asked to stay at home by our government officials, we've also been asked by our spiritual leaders to use this time to think and reflect on spiritual things. And as I've done that, one thought keeps coming to my mind, and that's the idea of having a grateful heart. Colossians 3:15 says, "Let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, since as members of one body you were called to peace, and be thankful." Of course, the biggest blessing that we thank God for is having peace with God, being at peace with the Lord, and also having that peace that passes understanding in our hearts. But I think it's interesting that this passage immediately links the next command, which is to be thankful. And being thankful is more than just having an attitude of gratitude, but it's doing something. And I think one of the things that we do to be thankful is to really consciously and deliberately, intentionally think about what the Lord has done for us. Psalm 103:2 says, "Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits." So when I want to not forget something, I usually make a note to myself. I write it down. And so I decided to write down some of the benefits that the Lord had given me in order to help my own mind be able to reflect and think about what God has really done. I encourage you to do the same thing. Take a paper and pencil and make a list of the benefits in your life. I came up with two general areas. One of the benefits right this very minute that I'm enjoying, and others are benefits I may have taken for granted, which I'm now coming to appreciate a lot more. So while I'm stuck at home, some of the benefits I'm really enjoying and thanking the Lord for right now are, I'm told to stay home. I have a comfortable home to stay in, and I thank him for that. All the provisions. The food. I have a pantry and a freezer full of food that I thank God for. I have friends and family that are reaching out to me and calling to check on me, and that encourages me and makes me feel loved. I have technology to help keep me connected with others. I have my health at this point, and if I do get sick, there's access to medical care if I need it, and I can thank God for both of those. I have God's word in my hand that I can go to anytime, 24 hours a day. I have Christian music and other Christian resources both in my home in hard copy and also online available to me. And I have the peace of God in my heart. Those are just a few of the things that I can count right now at this very minute that are tremendous blessings to me, and I want to consciously acknowledge those to the Lord and thank him for it, and speak to those around me when I do talk to them to remind them and myself of these benefits. There's also those benefits that I may have taken for granted in the past, and I'm now realizing what a blessing they are. The companionship of a spouse. Sometimes we take each other for granted, and just having someone to talk to face, what a blessing. The opportunity to practice hospitality. We enjoy hosting people in our homes, and when we're not able to do that, I realize what a blessing that is, what a privilege it is to be able to do that. Sharing a meal with friends, whether it's at a restaurant, a potluck, at church, or whatever, just breaking bread together, it's a huge, huge blessing. The freedom to travel when and where I wanted. Definitely took that one for granted, just being able to go across the city, across the state, across the country, whatever, and the freedom and ability to do that. Worshiping together with other believers. I love all of you, my brothers and sisters in the Lord, and I miss you. I miss being able to worship together with you. Opportunities to serve in the church, you know, being asked to do a job here or there, whatever it is. What a tremendous blessing that is to be given that opportunity and to say, yes, I'll do it. I want to do it. And then, of course, God's promise to never leave me. Whether I'm out and about or stuck at home, the Lord is there and his promise is precious. Will you pray this prayer with me? Lord, give me a grateful heart. Thank you for difficult times that remind me of all your benefits. Thank you for the gift of relationships. I thank you for putting people into my life that love me and that I love. May I never take that gift for granted. Thank you for never leaving us. Help us, Lord, to be thankful. Amen. I hope you'll make that list, and I hope you will count your blessings.